Hi friends, today let's solve questions related to digital electronics in 2017 Telangana ESET question paper related to electronics. So which of the following is not an octal number? Here you have to remember binary number system has a base 2 and it has only two digits 0 and 1. For octal number system, it will be having a base as 8 and it have digits less than 0 to 7. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it will be having values which are less than 8. So if you observe this 3, they have a value which is less than 8 or in between 0 to 7. However, 99 is greater than octal number 8. So 9. So this is not a octal number. Also remember, a decimal number system will have a base 10 and it will be having numbers between 0 to 9. And similarly, hexadecimal number system will be having base as 16 and the digits will be 0 to F. You have 0 to 9 and then A, B, C, D, F. Next, the complete set of only these logic gates are designated as universal gates. Remember, what is a universal gate? Universal gate is a gate which can implement any Boolean function without the need of any other gate type. So only NAND and NOR are only the universal gates. Also remember, these two gates are economical and these gates are used in all ICs in digital logic families. Next, the gates required to build a half adder are, remember how does a circuit of a half adder will look? So this is the simplest notation. Of implementing a half adder, remember this. So this is your carry expression. So here you will be getting your AX or B, which is the sum expression. So you will be requiring 4 NAND gates and 1 AND gate. So this 1, 2, 3, 4. Here you will be getting the expression AB bar plus A bar B. So that is implemented by this part. And this is the carry expression. C is equal to A into B is in this case. So answer is this. Next, read and write capabilities are available in RAM. So generally in PC, RAM is used to hold the operating system and any open documents and programs that are running. So RAM can be read or written, and the contents of the RAM can be changed at any time by overwriting it with other data and instructions. Okay. Next, which of the following type of ADC is fastest? Now I will give you a table which you have to remember. So we have 4 types: counter type, SAR, flash type and dual slope. So the number of clock pulses in case of a counter type ADC is 2 power n minus 1 and the time taken by it is 2 power n minus 1 into T clock. In a SAR, it will be taking n clock cycles, and the time taken will be n into t clock. And similarly, for flash, the conversion will happen in a single instant, which means one clock cycle, and it will take t clock cycles. Now, if you observe which is the fastest, it will take only a single clock, so flash is the fastest. Whereas 2 power n plus 1 cycles will be taken in case of a dual slope, and the time taken is 2 power n plus 1 into t clock. So remember, the fastest is t clock and the slowest is dual slope ADC, analog to digital converter. Try to remember this table, it is very much useful. Next, if the counter is connected using 6 flip-flops, so n is given as 6, then the maximum number of states that the counter can count are, so the maximum number of states is given by the formula 2 power n, so 2 power 6 is equal to 64 is the maximum number of states which can be counted. Next, the counter that can be used for measurement of, generally counters are basically used, are capable of measuring frequency and time along the counting process. So these can increment memory address according to the application. These are used in various digital applications such as A2D converters, digital clocks, and frequency dividers, and even timing circuits. So time and frequency are the two things which a counter can be used for. A n variable, so I'll solve this in the next problem one. So the Boolean expression here for a n variable, Boolean function, the maximum number of prime implicants are, so if you remember, if you take a 2 by 2 K map, what is a prime implicant? So a prime implicant of a function is an implicant that cannot be covered by more general or more reduced, meaning a literal. So if you see 1 and 1, if they are covered by this, and 1 and 1, if it is covered by this 2, now there is no need of this. So only, so here prime implicants are 2 in number, so you will be having them denoted by 2 power n minus 1. So it is proved that the maximum number of essential prime implicants in a Boolean expression with n variables is 2 power n minus 1, or the number of its canonical terms t is less than 2 power n minus 1. Try to remember this formula. Next, the minimum number of 2 input AND gates required to implement a 2 input XOR gate. So here also you have to remember a particular table. The table has, so first NOT gate, AND gate, OR gate, XOR gate, XNOR gate. So if you want to implement this particular gate by NAND gates, so the numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now if you want to implement it by NOR gate, you will need one NOT gate, and these two gets interchanged, 3, 2, and these two gets interchanged, 5, 4. Now what is the question? Implementation of XOR gate using an AND gate. The answer is 4. Hope you understand it. So with this, the questions related to DE in 2017 TS question paper are completed.